I was always scared of this bird. My god, that was so creepy. Hello everyone and welcome to another video here at Bliss. Today we are going to be analysing who sang best this amazing track, Poor Unfortunate Souls, from The Little Mermaid. We are going to be looking at different performances. We're going to start with Pat Carroll 1989 version, and then we're going to see The Little Mermaid Live that took place in 2019, and then we are going to see this amazing performance that I've reacted to of Blue Sarah in 2022, and we are going to land into Melissa McCarthy. So let's get to it. Let's start with 1989 Pat Carroll.
I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch.
Already, how deep her voice is, it helped. It kind of made me feel that there is some deep-rooted bad vibe in there. Also, the pace and she's singing, like, very manipulative. So that already helped. Nasty. Well, a witch. These are very, very round words. She took the time to kind of, like, colour those words very, very well.
Repentance in the blood and need a switch. Yes.
Oh, true. Yes. Ooh. That's a big distance. True. Yes.
Poor unfortunate souls in pain, in need.
That's a lot of like mid to very, very low range. There's not much resonance or brightness in the high notes. It's going from kind of like a more theatrical approach. Pat Carroll was a comedian. I'm not very sure about her vocal training as a singer, but even though it sounds fantastic, it sounds very good. Now let's have a look at the 2019 live version of The Little Mermaid with Queen Latifah.
They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. Don't you find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light and made a switch to thee.
Well, this is life. So obviously the way we capture the tone is different. I think the pace is already, it's more aggressive, it's a little bit faster.
They come flocking to my court and cry, tells us and appease and I help them up. Yes, I do.
I'm not sure. I think the whole mesmerizing aerial into falling for the spell here, like, it's missing. Vocally, she was more confident, but still, I would have preferred something that would have made me fall for the spell a little bit more.
Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint!
It's a saint! There's a lot of more upper range here.
You have your looks in any case. And don't forget to underestimate the opponents of body language.
I didn't like the extended version of the body language. I think they tried to make a point there that I don't know. I think Pat is winning so far. I mean, this is an all-time classic. It's just something that is in many, many ways so amazing. We haven't been seeing this very traditional villain that much, like the evil queen from Snow White or the Cinderella's stepmother or like Jafar's Scar. But for example, Moana doesn't have a villain, and Frozen doesn't have a villain. And you know, it's kind of like this very important character in the Disney movies is kind of like fading away. So let's see now that Pat Carroll have won this first round to see what it is compared to this Broadway singer, Drew Sarish, and to see how it goes.
I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They were kidding when they called me a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light and made a switch. True.
So this is already giving me something I didn't expect, and I love very much. This is kind of like reviving the drag queen vibe that actually gave the look of Ursula that we know today. So Ursula was inspired in A Drag Queen Divine, which was big in the 80s, and by just getting Drew Sarish to have the same look is already bringing all of that back, which I love.
Poor unfortunate souls in pain, in need.
You see, there's a lot of resonance here. There's a lot of that twang that we like from singing, that the phrase actually demands. Poor unfortunate souls. And also, it gives more chance for vibrato. I like the brightness of it.
Poor unfortunate souls. So sad, so true.
So sad, so true. Big changes there. This for a male range is not easy. Amazing choice there. It's beautiful.
They come flocking to my call and crying, spells, Ursula, please, and do I help them?
Spells, Ursula, please. It's very good. It keeps space. You can see that his vocal technique is amazing.
But on the whole, I've been a saint.
Beautiful note. Saint. Beautiful, wide, very well resonating note. So let's compare this with Pat, because we are trying to compare these two together.
But
I was always scared of this part. My God, that was so creepy.
This poor, unfortunate
soul. No! Bringing the note to a lower range. That's good. So let's see how what Drew does.
Poor, unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make a choice.
It's constantly in that higher upper range there. The rhythm is still good. It's as good as bad. Obviously, this is less theatrical. This is more singing, but singing with a nice consistent rhythm, which is very good. And then it keeps giving you that hint of, yeah, I'm giving you this amazing high note.
I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much. Just your voice.
This is one of my favorite part. It won't cost much,
just your voice.
That switch there, I mean, we have seen this in this song and other performances, that change from very high note for something that is longer than an octave, which is called compound intervals. But the vocal fry there, the actual look, everything all together, it makes me, ah, my God, this is so scary. It's already kind of like a higher performance in a sense. Like, there's a lot going on there and it's all going on well.
Flotsam, jetsam, now I've got her, boys. The boss is
on. That's proper evil. Look at that.
Then go ahead and sign the scroll. Flotsam, jetsam, now I've got her, boys. The boss is on a roll.
Amazing note. Perfectly placed.
With this poor
I mean, we saw this coming. Now let's watch it one more time, and this is directly to all of my students. When I mean open your mouth, I mean this. This is what I mean, right? Drew Sarish, it just showed everything. Showed the acting side and the singing side. Amazing vocal technique, amazing range. So now let's do Melissa McCarthy. Yeah.
I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways. Repentance in the light and made a switch. True. Yes.
Oh, this is very interesting. So Pace is there. She has changed a few things. For me, forever, she's going to be Zuki St. James from Gilmore Girls. And she was super sweet there. So for me to get that figure into this evil character is going to take me time. But so far, I like what she's done. She has kept this first section completely different to everything else, which I like. I like the pace, I like the rhythm, I like the way everything sounds as theatrical as Pat, but sounds still musical. Even though she doesn't have a history of singing, she sang a song from another musical with Barbra Streisand, and that's already a sign of, you know, showing some interest into her vocals.
Unfortunate songs.
So So what happened is that before it was so sad, so true, but then she changed that. Instead of having those jumps, those very massive intervals there, what she's doing is that she's adding dynamics instead, and that works very well. It gives you that feeling that there's a voice there, there's a change there, there's talent there, there is a thought there, but at the same time it comes to place with the softness of, yes, I'm trying to make you think I'm a good deal.
They come flocking to my cauldron. Great spells, Ursula, please!
Love this!
No, it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I have to rake across the cone. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been saved.
That was a nice slide with a little bit of a vocal growl at the end. That worked very well, very well. For the purpose of the movie, I kind of like this one more. It's more theatrical. Okay, I need to make a choice. Go ahead, make your choice. I think I'm going to go with the Drew Sarich version. There's a lot going on, and I mean, it's still, I can hear Melissa. I can still think about Melissa when I am watching and listening to this. Whilst when I am listening to Drew Sarich, I actually see Ursula. And that's something that is very valuable. It's not I'm a singer and I'm just singing this and I'm showing what I can do as a singer, but the acting of it, I actually believe that performance, and I mean, there's a lot of experience there. So yeah, I think between these two, Drew Sarich, Poor Unfortunate Souls has won the contest of Ursula, who sang it best. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it was as amazing to watch these performances as it was for me, and I'm going to see you in the next video.